when you get a clemency, that's just not something that's given every day to everybody.
Earlier today, I commuted the sentences of 95 men and women who had served their debt to society. Another step forward in upholding our fundamental ideals of justice and fairness.
And it's like winning the lottery to me, and I don't take that for granted.
The release is about to come.
Out of 30,000 applications, and I'm one of the ones. And when I sit back and I think about that, I tear up because you just don't get that. That just don't happen. If I had nothing else in life, I have freedom on the outside. Now, something that I asked for a second chance for that, and I have it, so I would not dare mess it up. The past right here. I would not look back. I left a lot of friends behind. So it's like I give them hope. And if it happened to me, it can happen to them. Just hold on to the faith.
I don't even know how. I think I'm still kind of like in shock.
Somebody had to speak out for me is the only reason why I sit here today. Without Obama signing me out when he did, I probably wouldn't have had a chance. 17 years was a lot.
That was too
and
much.
I always said, I only do what God allowed me to do. And 17 was it. 75% of the women that I met incarcerated is serving mandatory minimum sentences.
We
were
in class room together.
She was like everybody's mom.
I just want to touch them in some type of way. At least be a voice, because in prison you have no voice.
Being in the prison system, it's dark. It was very dark for me. First time nonviolent offense, they gave me life. I done 17 years in prison. I'm happy to be out. I just feel like I'm a walking miracle right now.
I can say all day long that I'm not afraid, but it's times when I am afraid. I just know what I left, and a lot of things has changed now. I was incarcerated with my mom. She died in December 19th of 2012. And that's when I started the dreads on my hair. I said, if I'm never released, I'll never cut it. But upon my release, I'm cutting it.
Shedding all the relief, all the pain, all the hurt, all them years, all the time.
I wanna just do some stuff. I wanna build my relationship with my daughter. I can get to know her better because I've been gone since she was 8. It's been that long. And at the end of the day, I'm her mom. I want to be that mom to her. It's a lot of kids that's out there in the world that don't have a mom. And I know what it feels like not to have a mom. And I know how my daughter felt. I just want to share some of my feelings, be a listening ear, just be a server.
The hair is gone.
I'm free. Losing the hair was my freedom. My second freedom.